Greetings, everyone. Thank you for tuning in for Inward Market. And I'm your host for this week's episode. And the topic of this week is perseverance. So first, perseverance is the ability to pass a test with flying colors at all times. It's a guarded spirit, always on point and on guard for the least expected. It's a commitment when your choice is to earn the prize, the crown that leads to eternity. Are we on point when we need encouragement and the very vessel that brought us into the world seems to not be around at the prospective time that we really need them? And where do we gain that encouragement to enhance our situation? How do we push through it? We must pray for strength during those times and at all times so that we do not lose our minds through difficult times. We must be committed and determined to stay within the perimeter of the Holy Spirit, affirming and confirming that we are a child of God, flowing in the spirit of love at all times as we persevere when it seems God is existent and non-existing within our life when we need Him the most. Do we persevere? We must understand that the times that are difficult, it can oftentimes give us the discernment that that situation or difficulty is not for us. That is when we must pause and wait on the voice of the Lord, the voice of observation, the voice of evaluation, the voice that warns us to proceed with caution. He is always near. But we push the Spirit of God to the side when we are committed to different things such as addictions and things that does not include Him, but we want Him included when it's beneficial to us, lifestyle that does not include Him, meaning committing crimes to satisfy materialistic things and things that diminish our character. We must remember He is our strength when doing anything pure or good and fits within His characteristics. These characteristics are His nature. Anything else is flesh getting in the midst of our sanctity and our sanctification, our purification. We must take charge of our crown of perseverance. The key to eternity, we shall wear a crown. What will we allow our crown to consist of? Dealing with life with the spirit of contentment will give us more benefits than anything else because we have established living in the will of God, which is the spirit of thankfulness, making a way out of no way, and expecting the unexpected to overflow through faith manifested into a solid foundation of perseverance. We persevere because we have faith. Otherwise, we would give up and give into fleshly desires. Desires that mean us no good. Our faith must be solid as a rock. Belief under pressure, wearing our crown. As we persevere, doing misunderstandings, we wear our crown. As we persevere, which is the beginning point of our faith and at the end point of believing in His promises, having the commitment to seek knowledge and gaining the necessary wisdom to persevere and obtain a sustainable life, especially through the things that we have not been given answers because we're sluggish in our search. Not seeking the kingdom first, but we must seek the kingdom first within us, finding God, finding His image within ourselves, and mastering the gifts that He has supplied for us. We persevere and we continue to seek within ourselves so that the eyes of our understanding, the eyes of our spirituality will be enlightened. The gates of wisdom do not knock on the door of our hearts, but we knock and the door begin to open with truth and answers that unlock ignorance and opens the door to clarity. Clarity seals the deal, seals our faith. When there is no evidence, there is no substance. If there is no substance, then therefore there is no faith. What will we be having faith in? What will we be believing in? God doesn't want us to believe in things that's non-existent. We must seek, find the evidence, find the knowledge base, which is power, which is kingdom. Okay, and therefore our faith is invalid if our works remain in vain. So our beliefs must become sufficient. Have you ever been to a bank? Or a bank? Have you ever been to a bank? And somehow it just said, insufficient funds, and you knew for sure that you put this certain amount of money in the bank to cover what you need to do. But you knew. So anything that you know is a solid foundation, is solid as a rock, and you don't need to question. You don't have to go in the bank and say, oh, I don't know what happened. I'm not sure. You know. So that's the way our faith is supposed to be. You know. Persevere on your faith. Persevere on the kingdom being valid in your life. That's what makes us stronger. That's what makes us master our gifts and have the capability we need to love on one another, to be kind to one, be kind to ourselves. When you be kind to yourself, you fall within the perimeter of the desires that God will have for His image. He created us in His image, so we have to take care of ourselves to be able to have the capability and the desire to take care of someone else. And so we persevere through the trials. We persevere through temptations. We persevere through trials and tribulations because of our faith and our belief that our Master got our back. So we must have enough evidence to win this case, to win the race for ourselves. We must be held accountable for our own action, making truth find as a reality for longevity. Hebrews 10:26-39 will outline in depth the way we enter the holy place through the blood of Jesus is by changing our mindset. People are saying, what is this new stuff this woman is talking about? It's not about new stuff. It's about getting clarification of the stuff that we need to push forward, to move forward. Okay? And when we change our life, all things will become new. All things will sound new because all things will become new. But if you're in that same old mindset of not uplifting and being positive, speaking positiveness into your life, knowing that you're worthy, knowing your self-worth, knowing that you are capable to push forward and have the desire to change your life for longevity. Okay? So we will begin to change our lifestyle when we begin to change our mindset. Change is not a given. Change is desired to be acquired. Efforts, daily communion, prayer, medication, supplication, and positive influences. If we are surrounded by negativity, we will become negativity. Then after that comes sluggishness. Then after that comes non-productiveness, which leads to a life that withers away. So when we persevere, we gain strength and the power to have a desire to change, which will come upon us when we activate the principles. We will begin to interact with one another differently. Okay, persevering in situations that test our faith, test our beliefs, test our love. Have you ever had to continue to reach out and love on someone that was constantly giving you the cold shoulder, but you stood on your faith that this person will love you back? And if not, love on yourself, love on someone else. Eventually, the love that you gave that person will come back to you. It might not come from that person, but eventually it will come to them. And they, oh, I remember that person that loved on me and I was mean to them, but that person still loved on me. It will be in the back of their mindset and they will remember. They might not tell you, but they will remember you, because our faith is persevering. We develop the belief that love conquers all issues and disappointments. Persevering is a conscious way of living. Remain in a conscious state of mind of God's character, existence in our life, which will assist in keeping our head above water. When we live a conscious life, we live a life of perseverance. We will have a life filled with happiness and joy. Demonstrating a conscious life is when a person is actively evaluating their activities, decisions, and options. The choices and decisions we make become healthier, become more productive, which will confer based on the individual's determination for mental balance and stability. Living life on purpose for His design purpose. It's simple. Being thankful, grateful, happy when things are not going the way we planned. But we learn to improvise. We learn to persevere. We learn to be content and live within the will of God. Watch the table become plentiful, a fuller fridge, a fuller gas tank, a bigger house if you desire it. It's like when we were children, we took pride in small things. Our parents provided us with bigger things when we showed gratitude, gratefulness. But my point here is there's not a whole lot to life. Life is in a nutshell. And we learn not to be nuts in the way we live in it. I remember wasting time on things that were irrelevant, and now I spend more time being grateful for what I am and whose I am and the joy I feel of who I'm becoming and transforming into. And thank you for listening.